Professor Sanchez de Madariaga, we are delighted that you have agreed to do a short video interview with us for this occasion of the COS Connect on advancing gender equality in research and innovation. As agreed, we will discuss a few questions in the context of the COS Targeted Network on Gender Equality, the Gender STE, which ran between 2012 and 2016. And we very much look forward to hearing your experiences as the chair of this network. So first of all, let me ask you if you could please tell us a little bit about the overall objectives of the first cost-targeted network on gender equality, gender science, technology, and environment, the Gender STE.
Thank you so much for inviting me. It's really my pleasure to be here sharing some ideas with you. Well, the objective of this first policy driven, it was both the first gender action addressing gender issues, and it was also the first policy driven action. So it had these two innovative approaches. And the objective was to help introduce gender dimensions, both as regards gender equality among women and men in scientific and technological institutions generally the science and research system, and also to introduce gender dimensions into certain specific areas, that is urban planning, transportation, and climate change. So it had these two objectives, and it focused both in research. So we addressed researchers, and we supported the younger generation of researchers in these specific areas that would start developing skills to address gender dimensions into these areas. And we also supported decision makers into academic institutions and research institutions. And we also had a task force with private sector organizations, quite some very important private companies, including, for example, Bosch and Oluf Bagsin and some others, Gigaset as well. And we addressed also innovation in industrial design processes.
Okay.
So we have these twofold objectives. Yes.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's very clear. Thank you. And in your opinion, what are the key outcomes of the Gender STE? And do you think they're still relevant in today's research and innovation landscape?
Well, I think this action was very successful. We had 40 countries participating, practically all of the EU members and many from accession countries. And we, in fact, we had representatives from countries from all over, from all five continents, with around 200 members continually participating, and we reached out to a total of maybe 800 persons. And to give you an idea, we published 8 position papers, some of them consultation papers on the European Research Programme, some others on the New Urban Agenda by UN Habitat and by the European Union. We funded 37 short-term scientific missions, mostly by young researchers. We held 13 workshops and training events to decision makers and to researchers across Europe, and most of them in Eastern European countries, inclusion countries. I think that's the word they had, the name they had at the time, because this was one of the objectives of COST, was to support and to impact primarily on countries in Eastern Europe. Mm-hmm. We held 6 international conferences, 29 working group meetings. So the impact in quantitative terms was very important. And I also think in qualitative terms, but because in many countries, this was the first time that many of the participants, and we had very high level participants from universities and from research public bodies. Some of the participants were quite high level, and it was the first time that they were addressing gender topics. So the impact in terms of integrating gender dimensions into decision making in institutions in many countries was very important at the time.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks a lot. And finally, could you elaborate a bit on the impact that Gender STE has had on gender equality policies in the countries and organizations that were part of the network? You already hinted at it a little bit.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Well, I think that one very important thing was to create the networks and the personal relationships. And because there were stakeholders from all these very diverse kinds of institutions, it was very rich, the exchange. So the personal networks, the personal relationships, the newer generations, the impact in actual decision making, the impact in the substantive content of policies, both in planning and transportation climate change agendas, but also in gender equality agendas in the scientific and technical and innovation institutions. So I think that the impact was quite significant, probably it was bigger in the countries that at the time were had less experience in the area of gender equality. But I think that overall, this exchange is really what has created also quite long-term relationships and outcomes that have been developing over the years after that, because many collaborative projects that emerged at that moment and many publications that were started at that moment have been appearing and having continuations in over the whole decade, almost since we started it. It's almost 9 years now that we started.
Yes. Oh, excellent. It sounds like it definitely had a very innovative character. It was an innovative action at the time. And the outcomes, as you described them, are very much ideal outcomes for a cost action. And it's so good to hear that the collaborations continued for so long as well. Thank you so much for giving us this comprehensive overview of the Gender STE Targeted Network. Despite the fact that you couldn't join us for the actual event, we are very grateful for your time today and for giving us this overview. So thank you very much.
Thank you to you. It was my pleasure. I'm really sorry. I'm really unable to participate tomorrow, as would have been my wish. But I'm very happy to have had this opportunity of recording these small comments. I hope they are useful. And I hope there will be other opportunities to join you at some other events. Thank you so much.
Thank you.